Good morning, everyone. But it's one thing to say it and another thing to mean it. Nobody likes to get up from their sleep. Well, not unless you have a beautiful day planned ahead of you. But then, plans are plans. And the best laid plans of mice and men often go awry. This is where we come in. We are here to ensure that nothing comes between you and your well-planned day. Namaste. My name is Vinay. I'm a teacher at the Yoga Institute, and we are here on a mission to help you seize the morning. In today's fast-paced life, dictated by targets, goals, KRAs, bonuses, and promotions, the scrutiny is endless. Add to that constant meetings, sales pitches, and presentations, and you are left wanting for that one thing that matters the most in all of this. Confidence. They say being nervous is sometimes good. It keeps you on your edge, makes you strive harder to achieve your goals. But imagine, if being nervous is good and it helps you strive harder, being confident makes you jump over all those hurdles. In a world where impressions matter, you don't want to wake up in the morning and dread the presentation that you are due to make in a couple of hours. You want to start your mornings happy, fresh, with a lot of confidence. And for that, all you need to do is hit your mat. One of the most important asanas that you can inculcate in your everyday practice to increase your energy is Garudasana. As the name suggests, it's an eagle pose. To do Garudasana, come up on your mats, stand with your feet together, look forward, square your shoulders, gently raise your both the arms at shoulder level, raise your right leg, wrap your right ankle around your left knee and do the same to your hands as well. Stay in this position for a couple of seconds, focus at a point in front of you and gently release your arms and your legs at the same time and release your posture. This is one of the finest asanas that you can inculcate in your daily practice to increase a lot of energy within you. This asana inculcates the bhava of gyan within you, the knowledge. It's a great asana for all your extremities, that your legs and your feet as well, as you have seen, every part of your body is involved within. And a great asana to improve your concentration as well. After the mighty eagle, it is time to unleash the strong and the fierce warrior within you. We are going to do a great asana which is called the Veerbhadrasana. To do Veerbhadrasana, please come up on your mat, take 3.5 to 4 feet distance between your feet, stand straight. Now gently turn one of your feet to one side and the other feet at 45 degree angle. Gently twist your body, square your hips, gently bend the knee so that it becomes perpendicular to the ground. Stand straight, gently raise both your arms up, put them in Namaste position and go back as much as you can. Stay in this position for a couple of seconds. Gently release your arms, bring them down, straighten your knee, gently bring your feet back to normal, and gently release your posture. As you have seen, it's a beautiful asana, a very graceful asana to inculcate a bhava of Aishwarya within you. Aishwarya is efficacy and self-confidence. As you're going against gravity, it gives you a lot of strength and confidence. It's a beautiful asana that can be done by most of you, but if you have certain issues like arthritis, problem in your knees, internal abdominal surgeries or back issues or cardiovascular issues or hypertension, blood pressure issues, try not to do this asana. Rest all of you can do this asana, a beautiful asana that can inculcate a lot of lovely energy within you to take on the day. And lastly, it is of utmost importance that along with energy and fierceness that you have developed with the asanas before, a cool, calm and collected mind is to be developed. For that, we have Yogendra Pranayam 4, which is diaphragmatic breathing, for which you have to sit down on your mat, gently lie down in the yogic manner on one side, turn on your back, keep your legs stretched out, arms by your side. Now gently bend your knees, bring your heels close to your hips, keep your knees together and feet slightly apart. Very gently place either of your hands on your navel, relax your neck. Now inhaling, make sure that your abdomen comes up. Exhaling, make sure that it falls down towards the floor. Inhaling, observe your abdomen come up towards the ceiling. Exhaling, observe as it falls down towards the floor. Repeat this for a couple of times. Very gently release your posture. With the help of your arm, sit up in any meditative asana. As you can see, it's a very simple pranayam, Yogendra pranayam number 4, which is called the diaphragmatic breathing, where we use our diaphragm to take in as much as air as we can, which is a great asana. It regulates your breath, it regulates your respiratory system, and more all, it calms your mind down. As we have seen, it's a very simple pranayam that can be done by each and every one of us. It's a pranayam that inculcates the bhava of knowledge, jnana, and vairagya, which is surrender. I sincerely hope and genuinely believe after following these power-packed yoga techniques, you are supercharged, confident, and raring to leave your mark on the day. Before you launch yourself ahead and take on the day, let us first hear from our guru and guiding light, Hansaji, lovingly known as Ma.
Namaskar. Every human is a unique personality. We are given with perfect body, mind, and soul. So everybody should feel confident. And why you should not feel confident? What's the reason? You have everything with you. You know what you are, you know your worth, you know you are sincere, you know you are hardworking, you know you are prepared well. Then why not confident? Confidence should be there. Rather, in Bhagavad Gita it is mentioned that Uddharet Atmanatmanam, Na Atmanam Avasadayet. Uplift yourself, never put yourself down. So just bring courage within you and just do your work. Come on. And don't feel negative. Positive state of mind goes away because of two reasons. One, that you have not prepared yourself well. You have not prepared from all angles. So that proper preparation, if you do, about any situation, any work, you will be better. And second, unnecessary anxiety and tension. Unnecessary thinking. When human mind is supposed to focus at work and not think about anything. Free mind is devil's workshop. The moment mind is free, it's going to think negative. And so try and see that you focus on your work and do it confidently. Tell yourself that, come on, I'm starting and I'll be doing it well. In life, why should we think negative? Why can't we think that everything would be beautiful? Every moment is like an adventure. That adventurous feeling, that looking forward feeling, that joyful feeling has to come to us and not negative thoughts. So every moment is new and we should feel excited about it, that something new will come up. And that's how we should move ahead in life. Well, next time when you feel low, what you should do, you know, instruct your brain that keep a smile, a gentle smile, and your back should be straight. Go ahead in life and think good. And you will notice that when you start doing all these things, positivity just pours in. Situations will become much, much more cordial. Well, so every situation is an adventure. Just enjoy, do your part well. Keep confident and move ahead in life. Yes? Namaskar.
If Hansa Ma's kind and encouraging words do not fill you with confidence, then what will? Hope you enjoyed watching this episode. If you did, do not forget to hit the like button, share this video with your friends and family, and put a smile on their face too. Comment below if you think you have any morning issues that you want us to help you with. Last and not the least, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to get notifications of our videos. We will be back every weekday at 7:30 a.m. in the morning. Until then, Good morning. Have a wonderful day.